products.
Okay, lots of e-ink displays. Yeah. So we'll show some images and we'll go pop to the website to see all the options available.
Yeah, so I thought what we could do is, you know, we're going to end on a big note, but let's go to...
Chonker, okay.
Yeah, let's go to the...
Oh, great.
I have all the pages up if you want to navigate.
Yeah, can I nav?
Yeah, you're going to nav.
Oh, sweet.
Yeah.
Give me the steering wheel.
What? Yeah,
I haven't been drinking, I promise.
Yeah, and if you want, I can move you around if you want to be in the mirror, but I don't think you do.
No, I don't.
Okay. All right. So
it's bad enough to have to hear me.
Okay. You can start going through the products. This
okay.
way. All right, cool.
So we started last week by adding e-ink. So we had, you know, we did the mag tag, yay, and then we've added the raw displays because I'm finally able to get displays at a good price in large enough quantities that I can stock them. So last week we did the 2.13 and the 4.2 inch, which were nice and popular. This week we're adding more sizes, like the 2.66 inch, which is very similar to like the 2.9 inch, but monochrome and grayscale. We'll get demo images of the monochrome. And this shows it to scale with a feather. These are the bare displays. Like, we will have breakout boards, but these are people who want to use it with a bare display. So in that case, you need a driver board, something with a 24-pin e-ink connector, like our ThinkInk Feather, which is what I recommend. And this one is a tricolor version, so it's black, white with red. And one thing to note is that pixels can be either white background, black pixel, or red pixel. You can't like mix them like RGB, right? So it's like you can't get purple from mixing black and red. You can only have pixels one color or the other, but you can like use dithering effects to get a good look. We also put in the 3.7 inch monochrome, which, you know, is nice. This one cannot do grayscale at all. It's only monochrome. So it's like black and white pixels, but you get like 416 by 240 pixels. That's kind of nice. And then there's also a tricolor version. It's a tiny bit more, but you get, of course, that nice red highlight. We also put in, I have to go back to the new products. So we got the 3.7s, and then we also, the 5.83s are coming next week. The big one is the 7.5 inch monochrome. They haven't gotten the tricolor in, but this is like a massive 800 by 480 pixels. Maybe we can go to the overhead.
This is a big deal. Okay, overhead is, I made it gigantic.
Yeah.
So you could go up if you want.
No, I know. This is the, 3.7 inch, which I really like. It's like a nice... chunky. So it's like a size of like a business card or so. And you can see how fast it updates. It looks really good. And then of course you can depower it and it maintains the image, you know, even when depowered. And then this is the huge seventh. So this is the one I'm really excited about because I really want to do these projects with like, you know, massive amount of pixels. 7.5 inch monochrome. You know, and again, like fairly fast updates, only takes like a second or two. It looks so good because there's so many pixels. Yeah. You know, you can see it in daylight very easily. You don't need a lot of light because it's very high contrast. Black and white pixels, and we'll also have a version that's monochromatic as well. And then next week we'll show off the 5.83. I didn't get in this week, but we'll have a version that's 5.83. So we'll have more and more pixels. Okay, so let's go back to
we have some, you know, nice photos too. If you want to check it out, you can zoom into them and more. And then we have a lot of ways that you're going to get cool content on it as well.
All right, so we'll do that. So let's go back.
You want to go to the product page?
Because we have the the stars of the show. So the e-inks, we love them, but they're not manufactured in-house. So the stars of the show is, first off, we've got the QNC 5883 magnetometer. Now, we have a lot of magnetometers in stock, and so you're probably wondering, like, why do you have another one? Why not use the List 3DH or the List 2DH? I've seen this QNC 5883 used in a lot of quadcopters and robots, and I figured, you know, maybe people want a little breakout. It's a fairly simple sensor. I do like it has fairly wide Gauss range. It goes from plus minus 2 up to plus minus 30 Gauss, and you can... use it over I2C very easily. It doesn't have a very complicated driver. I go to driver in Arduino. We're going to have it available in CircuitPython and Python, so people can use this. There's also the QMC 5883L, but it seemed to be discontinued, and the P was the only subtype I could get. But still, I think, again, if you're doing robotics and you want something that uses this chipset. You know, now you have something plug and play with Stemma QT. And then the star of the show, this one is really fun. So we saw these cool clear shaft potentiometers, and there's a little bit of a gap between the potentiometer and the PCB. And so I could fit a little NeoPixel inside of it. And so, you know, in this demo, I just have a microcontroller reading the potentiometer and long read input and writing the NeoPixel output. And it looks like really awesome. The whole thing glows. And you could get a shaft that goes on it, a potentiometer knob that could go on it. But although it actually has more notches than a T18, I think. It looks like a T3 or something. But it also has this cute little notchy thingy here to show you where it is. Honestly, I've actually seen this potentiometer used without a knob, just as is, using the little divots here as a grip. It's easy to use. We have two sets of pads and some header you can solder on. The potentiometer, you get the negative and positive and center. And then for the NeoPixel, you get ground, power, and input. And then on the other side, output. So you can chain these together. And if you are using this as most people would, where you have the same power and ground potentiometer and LED, you can solder close the jumpers on the back, and that saves you two jumper wires. But this would be really cool. I'm designing a synth and I'm maybe using this. I thought this would be a great little breakout for people who want like a little bit of glow. You want to have some feedback coming in through your potentiometer. So check out the Neopod. That's the star of the show today.
Okay. And then is there anything else that you want to show in the new product section while we're here? Because, you know, this is a day of tours.
Well, we're going to have more food jams, but nothing yet. No, okay. I mean, we're putting stuff in. Like this week, a lot of stuff. Next week, not sure there's going to be as many products.
And then, because we have a couple minutes, because I wanted to give us a half an hour. Folks who are interested in Color E-Ink, we got that. These are the covers for the best thing ever.
Yeah.
If you have anything with USB, just get these. Like, trust me, you're going to save years of life. Anyhow, that's everything that's going on here. We're going to play some videos and more during the week.
Yeah.
And that's the new products.
Okay.
For this week, thank you, everybody. Don't forget to pick up something in the store.
That's pick up products. A ThinkInk Feather and that 7.5-inch display. Make something big.
Yeah, and we'll do a little bit of behind the scenes in a sec. So let's go.